In today's video, we're going to be addressing one of the biggest problems that I think Grand Theft Auto Online has, and something that I also feel like Rockstar really needs to fix. Now, I was inspired to make this video because one of my followers on Twitter, his YouTube channel is Born to Christ Live. I'll leave a link to the video that we're going to ultimately end up watching in the description in this video, so you can check it out for yourself as well. He does some commentary on it. And if you want sort of his insight on the situation, you can. So let me set the scene for you guys. Basically, what he was doing was a mission for his bunker. I think he was either retrieving some supplies or he was defending his bunker from getting raided or something along those lines. At the end of the day, it was a mission that had him doing something in a public session where other people could see it on the radar. And he was doing something with his business that was requiring him to do something. Now, in his video, he explains that the entire time while he's trying to do this, he's had someone following him around and an oppressor. Now, the only problem with that is that they've been in passive mode. And this is the issue I want to talk about. Why are players in weaponized vehicles allowed to go into passive mode? So Rockstar has this incredibly weird logic about this entire thing, because they've made some vehicles in the game where you simply cannot go in passive mode, like the Luxor Deluxe, the Swift Deluxe, and those vehicles have no weapons on them. Like, they literally cannot harm other players, yet you can't really enjoy them because you're fearful of getting shot out of the sky. So that's really unfortunate. There's other types of vehicles where they sort of balance it really well, like the Akula. The Akula, for example, is an attack helicopter. But the second you go in sort of off the radar mode, you can't use weapons. Now, I still think to a degree it's a little bit broken. There needs to be sort of a delay between when you come out of the invisibility mode and when you can get your weapons back. And same with the passive mode feature that it sort of offers as well. That way you can't just immediately flip back and forth like you kind of can in the Akula, but at least to a degree you can sort of balance it. And then there's the rest of the weaponized vehicles in the game, where you're basically allowed to go into passive mode at any time you want. You can go in and out of passive mode no matter the time, situation, or moment, and you can go from safe to the ability to attack at a moment's notice. So now that you have that information, again, we'll bring up the fact that this guy was being followed from the start of the lobby with someone on an oppressor. Now, this individual on the oppressor is sort of just watching as our user here is sort of taking care of the mission. He's ultimately defusing the bombs. He's dealing with the puzzles. And you can see this guy shows up and he's just sort of waiting out in front. And if you guys are sort of familiar with Grand Theft Auto Online, you know what's about to happen next. This guy takes his vehicles out. He has a new destination, returning them to his bunker. But then the inevitable happens. The guy on the oppressor gets out of passive mode when he knows he's safe, and then ultimately kills the individual trying to deliver the weapons. And what is the most cowardly thing of the whole situation is, as soon as this guy basically griefs the person that wasn't bothering the lobby at all, he decides, I'm done, time for me to leave. Like, that is the scummiest thing ever. So that right there is another giant problem that I think Grand Theft Auto Online has, that I think Rockstar really stacks like all the odds against you here when it comes to doing business stuff. You have to do them in a public session. You know, the people griefing have all the advantage. You have all the disadvantages. Now, I'm sure there's going to be people arguing, well, he did this solo. He's by himself. He's susceptible to something like this happen. Even if he had an army of other players around him. Like, for example, we're going to jump back to my gameplay now. I'm actually delivering some cargo. And there's a lot of people in the lobby that are helping me. And you can see I've sort of got this Air Force One squadron of defenders surrounding me. I'm pretty protected against really anything other than maybe an orbital strike or something like that. Even if he did have other players defending him, because he was using the passive mode ability, it's not like any of his teammates could have helped him prevent this happen. Because the second he went in out of passive mode, he just blew up the truck. So it wouldn't have mattered if he had gotten killed after that. The mission would have been over. So this is why this issue sort of reigns supreme over all the other ones, is because even if we were to have a protection squad, You know, even if you were being more careful with something like this, you'd still be put in danger by the fact that one person with a flying motorcycle, with weapons and missiles and lock-on targeting ability, can, for whatever reason, go into passive mode. So I think that is a serious change that Rockstar needs to make. And it's one that they've made in the past. If you guys have been playing Grand Theft Auto Online for a long time now, you know that Rockstar has made several tweaks to passive mode over the years that have changed different features about it. And this is one that I think they need to ultimately make a change to, because this right here is so frustrating. You know, the person we were watching was minding their own business. They weren't attacking anyone. They were just going about doing their business stuff in a relatively low population lobby. I mean, it's not like this guy was asking for trouble, like he was talking smack or anything like that. He literally was minding his own business, and then this is what ultimately happens to him. So to me, I think that's very unfortunate. I think this is something that Rockstar needs to fix. I don't know how high it is on their priority list, given where we are with Grand Theft Auto Online's life cycle, with what's happening with RDR2, potential other new Rockstar Games titles, GTA 6. So will this ever be fixed? Probably not. I think it is very, very slim. Rockstar will probably just say, you know, you should have been more careful. But overall, it's just another example of how Rockstar makes things incredibly unfair to players that are trying to do stuff with their business. I mean, literally, like, all the odds are stacked against you here. You saw the truck he was in. It was slow. It was unarmored. You know, it was his objective. He only has one shot at it. If it's destroyed, the mission is over. If that guy crashes his bike, he can always call in another one. So it just is really unfortunate. Like I said, I'm not sure what we can all do here to make Rockstar aware of this. I guess really the only thing you can do is support this video. You know, if you do think this is an issue, you can support it. You can drop a like, you can subscribe, you can leave a comment saying, yes, this is something that needs to be fixed. Because I'm not even sure, you know, all the Rockstar support tickets in the world would be able to stop something like this or even start a conversation within Rockstar. But it is worth a shot. And I would, of course, love to hear from you guys in the comments down below, or you can reach out to me on Twitter. Do you think this is an issue that Rockstar needs to fix? Let me know your thoughts, opinions, and more in the comments down below. If you did go on to enjoy this video, though, a like rating would, of course, be awesome. And also subscribe to my YouTube channel if you are new or you like daily GTA 5 videos like this. With all the way, guys, like I said, thanks so much for watching. Take care, and I'll see you guys in the next video.